What's up, viewers, and welcome to TV Box Top. And today I have a budget mini PC from Ace Magic called the AK1 Plus. This model provides some RGB lighting effects running on an Intel N95 12th generation Alder Lake CPU with some pretty good base and boost clock speeds. So up next, we look at all of its features and I'll do my usual performance testing, gaming performance and alternative operating systems. So stay tuned, that begins right after this. Welcome back. So in the box, it comes with the AK1 Plus model itself. One HDMI cable, a 12 volt 2.5 amps DC power adapter, a mounting bracket and screws, and a user manual. Its body is made of plastic and along the top edge, it has some RGB lighting effects and ventilation holes. For I/O to the rear, it has dual HDMI 2.1 ports, one USB 2.0 port, 1 gigabit LAN port, a headphone jack, a Kensington lock, and its DC power input socket. On the side, it has a power button, two USB 3.0 ports, and another USB 2.0. At the base, you have a detachable compartment for SATA expandable storage that you can detach completely for a lower profile. Here, I installed a 1TB SATA SSD as expandable storage for this review. So I've already booted into Windows and let's have a look at its basic system information. It shows here that the CPU is an Intel N95 processor with a base clock speed of 1.7 GHz running on 16 GB of RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. Under product key, an activation shows that the Windows operating system is activated. For some more details, Ada 64 Extreme shows that the Intel N95 CPU has a boost clock speed of 2.7 GHz as confirmed by GPU-Z and Geekbench 5 when placed under a CPU stress test. This CPU can be clocked at 3.4 GHz, but in this model, the maximum boost speed I'm getting is 2.7 GHz. It comes with 16 GB of Kingston 2666 DDR4 RAM at 1333 MHz. Its GPU is the Intel UHD graphics with a base GPU clock speed of 1000 MHz and a boost speed of 1200 MHz. It has OpenGL 4.6 and Vulkan support. Its audio adapter is the AlderPoint P HDMI. Its system disk is an M.2 SATA 3 512 GB model. You can also see the Western Digital SATA 3 1TB SSD I installed into the expandable storage compartment. Its network adapter is the Realtek 8821CE and it provides dual band Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.2. For features, it can do 1080p at 240Hz and 4K 2160p at 60Hz. It has HDR display, screen orientation to portrait mode, reverse portrait and reverse landscape. You get a dual monitor display duplicated or in extended mode. It can play 4K HDR AV1 videos without issues. Let's have a look. This is basic HDR 10. Here is an AV1 video. This is a Dolby Vision video. This is a Dolby Vision video with Dolby Atmos. this is HDR 10 Plus. This is Dolby Vision in the M2TS format. Please note, I discovered a bug in the display settings. When you try to enable HDR, it automatically switches back to SDR. And in order to turn on HDR permanently, you have to use the Intel Graphics Command Center. And you only get up to 30Hz when HDR is enabled. When connected to a 5.1 or 7.1 PC speaker system or via HDMI pass-through on an AV receiver, the Dolby Atmos and a DTS:X audio speaker configuration becomes accessible, and with it you can play every Dolby and DTS surround sound audio formats. So here it's connected to my 7.1 AV receiver, and let's have a look at the various formats. Here it outputs Dolby Atmos. It can also output Dolby Digital Plus. Here it plays Dolby Surround from a Dolby Vision video. Next, for optimal Dolby audio, you get a Dolby True HD.
Over here is the right channel.
For DTS audio, it can output DTS HD Master audio. And true DTS:X format, not virtual or neural X. For gaming performance, without an eGPU, its built-in GPU is not powerful enough to deliver a high-performance gaming experience. Here I'm playing PUBG on the Steam platform, and at 1080p on the lowest graphics settings, it's running at a abysmal 9 frames per second. For PS2 emulation, the struggle continues, as I couldn't increase the resolution higher than the native PS2. This results in sluggish gameplay. And now, a look at some benchmarks and where it ranks on my mini PC rankings chart. First, its RAM transfer speed and its M.2 SSD read and write speeds. Its 16GB of DDR4 RAM has a transfer speed of 4,120 MB/s. Its M.2 SSD has a read speed of 517 MB/s and a write speed of 479. In testing the speeds of its dual Wi-Fi bands and its gigabit LAN port, revealed that based on my internet speed of 315 Mbps, its 5 GHz band achieved my maximum speed. The 2.4 GHz band only reached 24%, and its gigabit LAN port also achieved my maximum speed. In testing, its Intel N95 CPU for single-core and multi-core performance, the Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark delivered a score of 790 single-core and 2,294 multi-core. In benchmarking its GPU, the 3DMark TimeSpy test delivered a score of 342. It also could not deliver an average FPS reading, as its performance was so low. In the AnTuTu benchmark PC version, it scored 277,122. And finally, in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 2,632. Here you can also see its video editing score and its web browsing score, all of which will be added to the chart. So the scores have been entered on my chart, and the Ace Magic AK1 Plus is at position 13 based on its PC Mark 10 benchmark score. So to view this chart, I recommend that you view it on a desktop or laptop and maximize it to compare all of its cores and features against other models in this list. To view this chart, see the link in the description directly below this video. So at this point, if you feel you have seen enough and have already decided if or not this PC is for you, then go ahead and check it out in the description below. However, there is so much more you can do in terms of alternative operating systems using its SATA expandable storage connector. For example, you can convert it into an Android TV box by installing Android x86 as a separate installation on a separate drive or SSD without touching your Windows operating system. Another operating system is Chrome OS, converting it into a Chromebook, and another is FidoS. If you are into coding, you can install a Linux or Ubuntu distro of your choosing. Showing you how to install these operating systems cannot be done in this video, as those require separate tutorials that require lots of time. I did a couple of tutorials in the past, but those are no longer relevant and need updating, so during the next couple of months, I will take the time to do these tutorials for you to follow. However, with all of these alternative options, today Android x86 is my featured operating system because they have some new and exciting developments taking place. Just 2 days ago, they released their latest version 16 of Bliss OS running on Android 13. And I must say, after months of ignoring their OS, I'm truly impressed with the work they put into this one. In it, you get the mobile version of Android 13 with the newest kernel that's now compatible with all 12th generation Intel CPUs and AMD Ryzen GPUs. Full access to the mobile version of the Google Play Store and Play services with access to 64-bit games that don't usually appear on 32-bit boxes and access to your saved games data. The most critical issue they fix when applied to Windows mini PCs is no audio via HDMI, only the headphone jack. In this latest version 16, that issue has been fixed and you now have audio via the HDMI port. You get root access for any app you want via the kernel SU custom root application. This means you can get root access for any app you want without compromising the entire security of the Android operating system. For performance, you get a blistering CPU clock speed of 3.4 GHz configured in 64-bit mode. This means you can run 64-bit apps and games. For display, you get the Mesa Intel graphics with a GPU clock range of 1200 MHz with OpenGL ES version 3.2. And with it, you get Vulkan support API version 1.3. With its built-in cooling fan, it idles around 27 degrees Celsius. And for decoders, you get AV1 and HEVC for the playback of 4K video. However, you don't get any surround sound audio decoders, and in my testing, you also don't get HDR. So with these specs on Android, you get high performance 64-bit Android gaming without any throttling or overheating whatsoever. So in summary, the AK1 Plus is an exciting budget mini PC that you can perform a lot of tasks on as a simple desktop computer. It can play 4K HDR AV1 videos and all surround sound audio formats. It struggled quite a bit with high graphics Windows games, so it's not recommended for this unit. However, I did find it very exciting to run alternative operating systems using its expandable storage compartment. So that, my friends, sums up this review. This video was sponsored by Ace Magic, and I would like to thank them for sending this mini PC for review. They are offering it as a budget model for those who want a good mini PC at an affordable price. So if you are interested, you can get it on their website with a discount, or you can purchase it directly from Amazon. See the links in the description directly below this video. So thanks for watching, and I would appreciate it if you would hit that thumbs up button to support my channel. If you are a first time viewer or just stumbled upon my channel, I would like to encourage you to click that subscribe button and ring the notifications bell to be notified each time I release a new video or decide to do a giveaway of one of these amazing products. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Stay connected and see you in the next one.